So Parshat Kiddushim. So din hi sa Parsha Kiddushim, mayroon ng Midrash Rabbah. Speak to all children of the children, speak to all the congregation of the children of Israel and say to them. Din hi naklaro na to nga dili usa ka tawo lang dili si Moshe ang gingnan ini kundi ang tibuok banay sa Israel. You shall be holy. Kinahanglan magbalaan kamo. Nisulti si Rabbi Kia may tungod ni ini siyang unhuna nga kining parsyahan nagsulti samtang nagtigom ang tibuok community. Tungod kay ang gihisgutan aning parsyaha is the essential principle of the Torah nga gitawagan ni Rabbi Libby the Ten Commandments or sa laing bahin gitawag ni siya ni Rabbi Akiba o Cardinal Torah, Cardinal Laws. Okay? So ningon din si Rabbi Libby because of the Ten Commandments are included therein. So kung tanaw na tugmayo sa Torah, as per record, kaduharagi litok or na record diha sa Torah ang Ten Commandments. Dito gisulat sa Deuteronomy sa Exodo 20 o dito sa katong gitawag o Deuteronomy, katong dito sa repetition. Sa dahang gihangyo ni Moshe ang makagagahom, sa dahang nakabalo na siya that his life is about to end. Moto nga si Moshe ni hangyo for 3 weeks to review the Torah to all into all the community of Israel. And Hashem granted the request of Moshe to review. And that the review of Moshe is the entire Deuteronomy. Muna gitawag na siya Mishnah, repetition. Repetition from Genesis up to Leviticus, Numeros. So tanang tura nga nasulti da sa Genesis paingon diri sa Numeros is na review na dito sa panahon sa Deuteronomy. So kaduha lang, pero kining istoryahan din sa Leviticus 19 gisulti din nga ang Ten Commandments is nahisgutan even though wala siya mahisguti literally. Halimbawa, niingon ang Ten Commandments, I am Hashem, your Elohim. Niingon dayon ang Leviticus 19, I am the law, I am Hashem, your Elohim. So, kung tanaw na tugmayo, gihisgutan niya, kung unsay gihisgutan dito sa gihatag sa makagahong, nga kang Moshe, pag-ingon sa Ten Commandments sa Aseret Hadibarim, you shall have no other gods before me. So, naingon po din eh, sa Leviticus 19, nor make for yourselves molten gods. Ayaw mo paghimo og mga linilo kalarawan. So, the commandments is itself as literally written in the Torah during the giving of Sinai and it is repeatedly written in Deuteronomy, it is also repeated in Leviticus in different ways. So, pag-ingon sa Torah, you shall not take the name of Hashem, your Elohim, in vain. Ayaw ninyo pasipalahi ang ngalan sa makagagahom or ayaw ninyo paggamita sa pasipala ang ngalan sa makagahom. Dinipod sa Leviticus 19, giingon po diri, and you shall not swear by my name falsely. Ayaw ninyo paggamita ang akong ngalan, ayaw mo pagsaad nga gamit ninyo akong ngalan. So, kung atong lang taon og maayo, ang 1 up to 10 is correlation na siya from Exodus, Leviticus, up to Deuteronomy. So, gisgutan diri ang napulo kasugo in other ways of speaking. So, niingon ang islik, al-shek, the Torah desires, however, is that a Jew should be part of the congregation of the children of Israel and be holy. So kung makita na itong maayo, dili lang karon panahuna, nagkatag-katag ang mga Hudiyo, ug muli kadasig sa pagtuon sa Torah. Mauna ang Torah sa kaniadto pa, nagdasig na o naghangyo, naghandom, nga unta ang mga Hudiyo is mahimong part sa congregation. Kay bisan sa unang panahon, daghan ang mga tao nga wala mahilig sa Torah. busa ang aslik na gingon, ang tura na gahandom, nga ang mga Hudiyo is mahimong part sa congregation o mahimo siya nga balaan. So din ay makita na ito pag-ingog, you shall be holy, meaning niingon ang Talmud Yevano 20a, pag-ingon og you shall be holy, literally the whole Israel, meaning that Israel should sanctify themselves, not only to the negative commandments, but also to the permissible one. Doon na mga mga butang gitugot nga naa sa balaod ni Hashem, nga although gitugot siya, but it is advised not to do these things nga permintin nimo ginabuhat. So the meaning of this, the Torah has warned against forbidden in any manner. Halimbawa, may ngontag forbidden sexual relation and forbidden foods. So naade sa Torah. Ang nakmanage nagsulti po, therefore, after enumerating the things which is forbids entirely to the Torah says, be holy, meaning constraint or restriction yourself also in that what is permitted. So although it is permitted, there is also restriction that do not do this permanently. Moto nga ni hatag og commentary si Rabbi Mordecai of Horoduk, pinaagi sa sulti ni Rabbi Senyor Salman of Liadi nga author sa Tanya, nagingon, what is forbidden was must not. Kinahanglan, kung unsay gidili, kinahanglan, dili yun na buhaton. But what is permitted, one need not. Even though that is permitted of other things. Pero kung wala gikinahanglan na sa panahon, then better not to do those things. Pagingon sa Torah, it is, you are permitted to go into the world and multiply. But mapasabot nga pangasawahon nimo ang tanan para multiply ang tao? No. So mo nang giingon si ni commentary si Rabbi Senior Salman of Liadi nga author sa Tanya. What is forbidden was one must not, dili ginabuhaton. Pero at the same time, niingon siya, what is permitted one need not. Isang pag permitted na siya, kung wala kinahanglan na, maayo sab nga dili. Padili kayo na ito, masabta, no? So Hashem then proceed to command numerous mitzvot. So kininga para siya, naghisgot niya daghag mitzvot. Many of which are cardinal precepts of Torah. So dinhi, kasagaran sa Torah, naghisgotan dinhi sa gitawag og is cardinal. Okay, for example, every man shall fear his mother and his father. Diba na may gingon dito nga, honor thy father and mother, at the same time you shall fear his mother and his father. Pero kung tanaw na itong maayo, honor your father and mother. Pero din hipod, balipod, fear his mother and his father. Kung honor ang isgutan, una ang father. Kaya nga naman na siya. Tungod kay ang Talmud Kiddushim 31a nag explain ani niya, usually good sa mga anak, ang gi-honor anak nilag maayo is ang ilang mama. Unya ang ilang papa is didto sila mahadlok. So ang Rashi Talmud, nagkumand na siya that you have to honor and fear them equally. So dapat equal siya. Dili ko mo kay pag-ingon, honor your father, father na po yung mong i-honor, niya yung mama, dili ni mo i-honor. It is revealed and known to Hashem that a person adores his mother more than his father and that he fears his father more than his mother. So Hashem therefore set the honor of one's father. Tungod kay dito sa inahan, dili na kinahanglan isulti nga i-honor nimo ang imong mama kay automatic na siya kay pirmi mo ikauban, automatic yun na nga ang anak mo honor yun na dito sa iyang inahan. Muna niingon ang Torah, honor your father first and the fear of one's mother. Tungod kay kasagaran sa mga anak, dili mahadlok sa mama. Although gatahod siya, pero dili mahadlok. Asa man mahadlok? Dito sa iyang papa. Muna pag-ingon po, fair, ang gisgutan po diag una is ang mama, fair your mother and father. Una permente ang mama, basta fair ang gisgutan. Mag-isgut po honor, unahon po ang papa. Tungod kay automatic ang mama gi-honor gyud na siya sa anak. Makita nato na sa Talmud Kiddushim 31:8. So naingon po din sa gitawag og cardinal sin na hisgutan po diri ang mahitungod sa sabat. And keep my sabat. I am Hashem, your Elohim. Kita nato din sa Rashi Talmud nagingon, although I have commanded you to fear your father, if he tells you to violate the sabat, giingnan sa makagagahong bisan to nagingon ko ninyo nga kahadlok kininyo ang inyong amahan, pero kung ang inyong amahan nagsulti nga supaka ang sabat or to transgress any other mitzvah or supakon ang ubang mga balaod, do not heed him. Ayaw tuon niya, for I am Hashem, your Elohim. Both you and your father are obligated to honor. So ang amahan o ang anak is obligado na mo-honor sa makagagaw. So ningon ang Rashi, do not turn to idols, nor make for yourself molten image. So, kung tanaw na tugmay kining mga balauran eh, pag-ingon keep my sabat, ang gisultihan ani Hudiyo. So ato naman ning na take up atong naging Sabado na dunay diferensya gamay kung ang usa ka nohayd is magtuman og sabat completely, then better for him and was advised by the rabbis to convert. But if you want to retain your status as Noahide, then better for you to follow the Noahide laws. And Noahide laws, the Sabbath is not allowed for Noahide. Although, nagatigong taong Sabado, but that is not a Sabbath according to the Jewish laws. Pero pag-ingon sa Torah, do not turn to idols, nor make for yourself molten gods. I am your Elohim. I am your Hashem, your Elohim. So dinhi nagsulti sa Ten Commandments na ana siya, number 2 na siya, pero dinhi sa Tua is number 1 na siya sa Seven Laws. Naana siya sa gitawag og idolatry. Og niingon si Rashi, nganong gisulti ni dinhi sa balaod tungod kay moingon magudaag. Buhat naman na, kuha naman na siya, kanang idol, kuha naman na siya, simbolo naman na siya. So ningon si Rashi nga karon simbolo pa na, pero moabot ang panahon nga simbahon na ninyo na. Just like what happened to the people of Israel during the time of Moshe. When Moshe was made the golden, the brass serpent. Primero, simbolo pa lang na siya para mohangad ang tao, pero pagdagan sa panahon, simbahon na siya. Munang ni pasidaan gyud ang makagahom nga do not turn to idols nor make for yourself molten gods, for I am Hashem your Elohim. So pag-ingon sa Torah, I shall not steal, you shall not steal, nor deal falsely, nor lie one another. So this is the equivalent of the Noahide laws nga nag-ingon sa negative laws, no to thief. So dili ka pwede mangawat. So naagyapon na siya sa Noahide laws. Ang pag-ingon, and you shall not swear by my name falsely, nor shall you profane the name of your Elohim. Naagyapon sa Noahide laws, kaning gitawag og blasphemy. So you shall not defraud your neighbor, nor rob him, ayaw siyang ilara, nor kawati. Kung ang sweldo sa usa ka tawo nga imong gihayar aron mo trabaho, ayag tugutin ang iyang sweldo, kupta nimo sa tibuok gabii. Hangtod buntag, kinahanglan isweldo ni sumala sa iyang demand. Pero kung doon na may kontrata nga, kada sabado lang ta sweldo og isugot siya, okay ra sab na siya kay nagsabot man mo. Pero kung moingon siya nga wala gyud ni bugas sir, pasulduha ko diha bi, then tagai ihatag sa iya ang iyang sweldo sumala sa iyang agi. So, and this parsha also, we have also about the charity to the needy. So the Torah said, when you reap the harvest of your land, you shall not wholly reap the corners of your field. O, sa ito pa, dili tilukon. This is the law of the Diyo. The nga dili nimo tilukon ang imong umakay. Kung imong tilukon, so may tabo sa other creation. So what will be the food of other creation if we reap the corners of your field? Nor shall you gather the gleaning of your harvest. Kaya mga nangausik, mo tigumon pag yun. Daginutan ka ika. So you shall leave them for the poor and stranger. I am Hashem, your Elohim, told you these all things. So nagsugo ang makagagahom nga kinahanglan sa panahon nga mag-ani kayog tiluki. And this law, although this is the laws of the Jew, but this is a law also for Noahide. Ang tawag ani niya, logical laws. Because other might, maka-benefit. Because other people might benefit from this law. Sa ato pa, ang tanang tura, all laws from the Torah which is benefitable by other person is allowed to Noahide to do for logical reason. Just like giving food to the poor, giving tzedakah to the poor. This is the law of the Jew. But as we see that this is allowed for Noahide because of the logical meaning of its laws. So that's why we can give tzedakah to other person in order to help them, to help other creation of Hashem. Dine po gisulti po ani nga parsha, mahitungod aning equality before the law. That all people, maybe you are a Gentile, maybe you are a Jew, a rich and poor, in the eyes of Hashem, we are all equal. The Torah said, nagingon ang Torah, you shall do no unrighteousness in judgment. Dili ka magbuhat og mga butang nga dili matarong kung ikaw maghukom. You shall not give special consideration to a poor. If you say that he is poor and yet he needs your help, then during judgment you will incline to the poor? No, it is unfair to the rich one. So you have to judge equally even if you are poor or if you are rich. Nor honor the great in righteousness shall you judge your neighbor. So kapag ka natin nakita pong arang-arang, ato na lang pong luoy na, suloy kayo ang mga pobre. So dinigi pakita ani nga parsya nga Hashem dili malipay, he is not happy when his people judge favorably to other side. So, dinhi makita nato, although this is also the law of the Jew, but it is beneficial to others. Therefore, it is allowed for Noahide to follow all these things because it is beneficial to others. So, the logical meaning of this Torah is applicable also for Noahide. So, this parsha emphasizes also the duty to get involved when another's life is threatened. Halimbawa, nakita ni mo gyud nga kung dili na siya dalhon sa ospital, mamatay na siya. So you have a mitzvah to save him, to bring him into the hospital in order to save him. So the duty to rebuke your fellow over his wrongdoing, halimbawa na ay diferensya, nakita ni mo nga mali, then you have also a mitzvah to settle those things. Dunay mga wrongdoing, na ay mga prohibition like slander, yung mga daot mag-isig kataw. Then gossip. Then sometimes you see somebody is taking revenge to other person and somebody is bearing a grudge. So we have to act on this. Although the Misiket Derek Eretz chapter 6 verse 3 nag-ingon, you shall not go about a talebearer amongst your people. You shall not stand by your people's blood. Ano daw? Although, dili ka pwede magdala og istorya nga to sa laing tao, nga again sa laing tao, pero dili ka pwede nga maglantaw lang kung unsay may tabo, humal, anang istorya ha? So kung kailangan ka mo istorya, then you have to do this. And if it's a mitzvah to act on it. So niingon si Rabbi Yitzchak, one who bears tales is a murderer. Kaya niingon ang Torah, you shall not go about as a talebearer amongst your people. You shall not stand by your fellow's blood. Although this is also, we are talking about the laws of the Job, according to Masiket Derek Eretz, chapter 6, verse 3, this is the law of the Job, but as I said, any laws of the Job that there is a logical meaning to other people, to the Gentile, then the Gentile is allowed to do these laws for the logical meaning, because other people might benefit the meaning of the laws. Bawal magdala og istorya ngadto sulod sa katilingban. Even we are not Job, but we are warned that if you do such things, then you consider yourself as a murderer. So, in Talmud Irakim 15a, so the Torah said, one evil talk kills three people. Mga nagasultig mga daot sa iyang isig katao, mupatay nagtulo. Number one, the speaker. Number two, the listener. Number three, the one who is spoken of. So as I said from the previous parsha, that evil talk or lashon hara is a very grievous sin, because it not kill only the speaker, but also the listener, and also the one who is spoken of. That's why the lobabicheribi, the speaker, obviously commits a grave sin by speaking negatively of his fellow. So, ang lobabicheribi nagpasidaan-daan nga ayaw ninyo nagbuhata tungod kay kung buhato nato ng pag-istorya o negative things about other people, it is considered as a grievous sin. Also, the listener is a partner of this evil. Naalag, isa may istoryahan o way na minaw. So, ang listener, anak niya, is also a partner of that wickedness. Pero ang pangutana ni Lubavitch Cherebe, ngano'ng na-appel man ang istoryahan? Ano affected man by their deed? Ngawa man siya ni-appel dito, pero siya yung istoryahan. But why is it that the third person was included in the sin? But why is the one who is spoken of affected by their deed? Are his negative traits worsened by the fact that they are spoken of? But the same applies in the reverse speaking favorably. Okay, halimbawa, kung nadamay ang katong taong inyong istoryahan, dili lang siya tungod sa kanang gitawag og lashon hara. Doon na po'y lain nga paagi nga makaingon ka nga you commit also sin opposite to the lashon hara. Unsa man na, kanang pag-ingon nato sa tuang kagalingon nga, uy, kanang, kuan ba, kanang, guwapa lagi kaayo kaay. Pero ang tinuod ko, dili igod to yung guwapa good kaayo, kanang igu-igu ragod po, di kita mo yung pangit, kaila sunara naman na siya. Mahitag, wala, guwapahan niya, ay, bisag, tanaw ko niyo, muna-una, gara, sabi sa igu-igu ragod to. So, bisan pag-idayag ni mo siya, bisan pag-idayag ni mo siya, it is still lashon hara. Uy, kumaayo niya mo istorya, Brad. Yan, nakita ni mo nga ni Garasad. Garasad, awig iganahan ko. So, mga ingunana nga paagi, this is also considered as lashon hara. So, in Midrash Rabbah, the psalmist compares slanderous talk to a sharp arrow. So, ako na nagsulti atong niaging mga parsya na to nga kining pana ang kanang daot nimo sa imong isig kataw is mura na siyang pana. Once itira nimo na siya, is layo kayo na siyang abot. Naara ka din sa Pilipinas mandaot unya imong istoryang tuas Amerika, ingon anak kalayo ang imong abuton sa pagpandaot o isig kataw. So bintaha tong tao nga mo draw siyang sword, tungod kay ang sword pag ingon nimo nga ako na ibalik sa sakuban para dili makasakit. Uy, dira, kay imo ramang gigunitan. Pero ang pana, dili na nimo makunit kung asa na siya. Paingon-ingon, anak, nag-reverse ang populasyon hara. So niingon ang Midrash Tehillim, so a person who unsheep a sword can regret his intention. Pwede siya magbasol and return it to its sheath, but the arrow cannot be, so lisod na siya. So mo to niingon ang Yalkut Shimuni, to what may the tongue be compared? Unsa may ikakumpara na to sa dila? Ang dila mura na siya kanang iro mga gikulong sa balay. O niya, dito sa sulod sa balay naapadyod siya kulungan. So kung makabuhi na siya, unsa may status anak niya? Kurang manok ba kung kulong ni mo niya, once buhian ni mo, taka naglukso. So yung nana po ng iro. Mau gani nga, kung tanaw na itong maayo nga to ang dila, gibutang na sa kinalauman, gikulong na sa itong ipon. O niya, naanay ngipon, gikulong pag ina sa itong lips, para ma-double guard gin na itong atong baba. Pero amang yun, lami amang yun mag, sige og storya og dili maayo sa ibang tao. Muna nga, ningon ang Yalkut Shimuni, secured behind the teeth. Bantayin nga dili makagawas gikan sa imong baba, sa imong ngipon ang imong dila. O niya, tabuni pag yun sa imong lips, para di gin kagawas sa imong dila. Yet it does no end of damage. Kung dilim ni muna buhaton, then the damage is a very grievous. That's why the Talmud Sanhedrin 73a, nag-ingon, pinaagi ni Rabbi Yosef Yitzchak of Lubavitch, surely said the Rebbe, you should know how grave is the sin of Lashon Hara. Kinahanglan makabaluka unsa kagrabe ang Lashon Hara. Speaking ill, sultig sakit, bahin sa bang tao, nowhere to my knowledge. Kining mga butana, wa jug ko makakita nga gisulti ni siya, nga gitugot diha sa Tura. In all cases, it is always prohibited. But the Tura also said that you shall not stand by your fellow's blood. So, dini makita na to na we know that if one sees his fellow drowning in a river, halimbawa malunod diha sa sapa, tungod kay nalunod sa daghan kayong istorya. So, ang usa ka tawo nga makakitaan na is obliged and must help the person drowned from a river or drowned from Lashon Hara. You have to speak to them. Do not do such a thing because such a things has a grievous and a very grievous sin. Rabbi Israel Baal Shem Tov instructed several of his disciples. So, dunay usa ka rabbi, si Baal Shem Tov, the leader of Hasidic movement, nga iyang giingnan na iyang mga estudyante nga, mga estudyante, pag-prepare mo kay manlakaw ta, natay adtuon. So, atuon man, kay siyempre, rabay ko ng kasulti, lahat ko ng master, muna ko na mga estudyante nga, usakay ko na puno, listen nga makuha na to aning lakawan. Because every time nga, mulakaw sila, mugawa sila, dunay kanang mga mensahe nga gustong ipaabot ang rabay, nga dili niya masulti, pero makita, pinagi sa mga lugar nga ilang atuan. So tuon man, they travel several hours until they stop at a wayside, and they saw a wayside inn because they feel hungry. That's why they stop. So Baal Shem Tov said to his disciple, which is a very pious one's disciple at that time, because during the time of Baal Shem Tov, the rainbows never seen. Tungod kay kanang mga panahuna, maunay panahon din daghan kaayong righteous dinhi sa yuta. So that's why they stop in a wayside with Baal Shem Tov together with his disciple, and they were considered themselves as a pious ones. So at the restaurant, they tried to order foods and they look for kosher foods. But when they heard that the restaurant is now preparing for their food, so some students go to the kitchen and make sure that they prefer correct, they prefer the food correctly. So siguro nila ba nga ang pagkaon tama pagyod? They check if the knife is The knife used is kosher. The also tantaran is kosher. The plate is kosher. The kanailang lungagan is kosher. So they check everything. They are very meticulous in their food. That's why they look everything into it. But there is one old man, sitting beside the urn, beside the cooking machine. What do you call this? So dito nakita nila nga naitigulang nga naglingkod dito sa kilid. The old man is very hard for him to talk with because he is very old, but he can able to speak. So he said to the Jews, the old man said to the Jews, are you as a careful with that what comes out from your mouth? You are very careful what comes. Hopefully you also careful what comes out because you are very careful of what enters into it. So the time the disciple of Rabbi Baal Shem Tov heard this, they fully understand what the rabbi is teaching to them. The lesson, you are very meticulous of what enters in your mouth, and yet you do not look what is outside in your mouth. So gisulti din ni sa lesson nga kung gi bantayan ninyo maayo kung unsa imong sulod, dapat bantayan ko ninyo ang mugawas diha sa inyong baba. Because ang mugawas is mas hugaw pa na kaysa ni sulod. Ngano man, tungod kay ang nisulod diha sa imong baba is kung makakaon kag hugaw, taman ra na pagsalop. After pagsalop, sa human ka nakaligo, mahimo na kang mahinlo sa tibuok. Pero ang mugawas sa baba, mahimo ning makapahugaw nimo sa tibuok nimo kinabuhi. So kung nagbantay mo sa inyong baba, kung unsay mo sulod, dapat bantayan sab ninyo ang mugawas sa inyong baba. That is the lesson of the old man wants to impart to the Jewish people in the restaurant. So Rabbi Baal Shem Tov laughed, and the Chassidim concluded their meal in silence, climbed up their wagon and turned it back towards their home, and understand the purpose for which the Rabbi Baal Shem Tov had dispatched them on their journey that morning. So nakasabot siya sa mensahe, although Rabbi Baal Shem Tov do not tell them with regards to the lesson, but they understand what Rabbi Baal Shem Tov is wanting for them to understand.